it is our heart's desire to serve you, Father. Lord, I ask you right now in Jesus' name. Let your word go forth and let it not go. hearts and our minds. Today, we yield to your glory, and we open our heart to the glory of God. It's not our life. We humbly surrender upon all of our natural mind. We place our dependence upon you right now. That God, you move according to your grace and mercy, and move in such an awesomeness. Open the heavens and give us favor in the name of Jesus, hallelujah. And let your people go forth in the name of Jesus, hallelujah. That you wash and cleanse us and set us free, O God. Bring us into the fellowship of your Holy Ghost and fire, hallelujah, hallelujah. Hallelujah, 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 hallelujah. Oh, the number son of the son of the Messiah. Oh God, let our hearts not be defiled by what others are saying and doing, oh God. Let us humble and stand in the gap and make up the heads. We plead the cause of your people that are walking in their own understanding. Let them come into the fellowship of your Holy Spirit, O God. Hallelujah. God, I pray now in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Release your divine favor and rebuke every devourer. crisis and so forth, then you will open the heavens and release your fire. Financially, divine. doors of hell. And let your people humble and yield to the living love of God. Hallelujah. Spare your people. Intervene even now this night. Hallelujah. You hear the cries of all the people that are not saved, oh God. We have the desire, a hunger for souls, oh God. Give us a hunger for the lost, oh God. Give us a compassion, how to reach for the people that need salvation in Jesus Christ. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Hallelujah, for soul of us, God, we recommit ourselves tonight afresh to you, Lord God. We ask you to sanctify us, wash our emotions and our thoughts, and don't let the cares of this life overwhelm us, O God. And let us not look at the circumstances, but we conquer and overcome, and we conquer every stronghold. We pull down every lie of Satan.
Thank you.
God, behold, you shall make all things new. Bid our old things pass away in our hearts and our minds. Lay aside our lack of confidence and lack of faith and our doubts and our fears. Lay aside every burden. Lay aside every iniquity and sin, oh God, that so easily beset us. Hear the cry of your children this night, wherever they're praying, oh God, that they will humble themselves and recognize how much of God they need in their lives, to come into the full maturity in total surrender and alive unto Jesus, oh God. Let your word come alive now. Let Christ be formed into our hearts, oh God. Let your love be formed into our mind and our thoughts. Let love be purified within our hearts, that we will be clothed with the holiness of God, that we will be crucified, and we will lay down our lives so that you can resurrect us, that your will be done. I pray, God, for a Holy Ghost revival. I pray for an outpouring of the Holy Ghost in this place. I pray the raising of your men and women of God and children to come into that place, that they will surrender to the living God. I pray, God, that you anoint me wherever you send me to minister to whoever you want to minister to, that, God, you will give the word that your people need, oh God, to strengthen and to heal them and bring them the assurance and confidence in the name of Jesus. I thank you, God, let us come into the full maturity, and let us have a compassion and understanding and a merciful heart for those who are growing in the Lord that have not arrived yet. And let us with tenderness and your love keep having faith and praying and praying that when they are converted, that they will then come into maturity. They will be able to strengthen others by your Spirit. And as you will come alive in the name of Jesus, I pray. Hallelujah. God, I pray that the Canadian citizenship will come in now, so, Lord, that it finally be healed. I pray it finally, God, all those blessings that you have promised, oh God, will now come to pass. No more tossing to and fro, no more wrestling, but pressing through, that you open the heavens and release your blessings, oh God. A restoration, oh God, breaking every curse, breaking the poverty. Oh God, that we can surrender to you and not no longer walk in the imagination of our natural flesh. But we will be able to do what we love, God. God, you know the souls that you want to save when I go to Finland. You know the people who need to be healed and restored, have the spiritual breakthrough in their lives, to bring a word into their lives that will set them free, to transform their hearts and minds to enter into the glory of God. Hallelujah. I pray now, God, open every door, every door that's being shut, let it open now. And anywhere else you want to go in Europe, oh God, you open the doors, whether it go to Sweden or Norway, Denmark, any part of the countries in Europe, oh God, England, hallelujah, wherever you want me to go, as you will go before me, hallelujah, 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 that you will then lift us up in the name of Jesus. And let all the old things, all the suffering and all the pains, all the hurts, be all washed away. Be it like they never was there. And creating us a new heart. The heart is like Jesus. His heart, divine heart, being formed within us. So that we can yield to you and you can have the preeminence in our hearts. God, that you can take over our thoughts and lives as we yield willingly. Hallelujah. Be not discouraged, my son, and be not overwhelmed. Surrender yourself and yield to my spirit, for I am with you. I want you to trust me, for I am preparing everything for your life. And though it may appear you're going to the fire, but the fire you're going through is purging you. In every area of your thought and imagination, and each time as you yield, each time as you humble, each time as you surrender, each time as you keep pressing in, I'm bringing you into that place of total victory. And God, you will just have your way. You will have your way in the name of Jesus. That God, you will manifest your glory, hallelujah. Hear me, my son, as you're yielding to my spirit is taking over your life. As you're yielding to my spirit and surrendering your natural mind, I am transforming you. I'm bringing you into the ministry of Jesus Christ. And I'm filling you with my holy anointing, the same spirit that was in my son. I put it in you. So you can let his spirit minister and strengthen your people to lead and guide, to shine the glory of God, to shine the mercy. You shall become a blessing, and you shall bless the people by my anointing. You shall bless the people as I lead and guide you, and I'm going to open the doors for you to go where you have never gone before. I shall go before you, and people will ask you to come to different places, and as you go, I go with you. I'll be with you to protect you and to keep you. And as you allow my peace and my love, as you allow me to put in your mortal body, then I will anoint you by my spirit. So my spirit will begin to bring healing to the broken hearts. deliverance to the captives, signs, wonders, to setting the captives free, even to the raising of the dead, even to the healing of the broken hearts. You shall be anointed by my Spirit to do a work that you have never dreamed that would come to pass. The word that I spoke by my servant, that you're going to get into that place that very few men has ever gone into. And I'm bringing you into that total place of surrender in everything, so that you will be sensitive to my Holy Spirit and know exactly what is in the mind of my Spirit. And you will be able to minister to those who are ready and to prepare others to get ready. You will have the knowledge to see what has happened in their minds and get the discernment and wisdom to know how to deal with it. And by the gift of faith and the working of miracles, I will manifest my Spirit, and I shall do wonders that it will astound the people in what I am doing. So listen to me now. Be not discouraged. Be not troubled, and do not look at how many people are always in the service. But look to me and realize, as you release the word, as you go on YouTube, there are thousands of people who will listen to these words that I'm placing in your mouth to speak. That is what they need to hear. Hallelujah. Yes, Lord. I will listen to you by your Spirit. I will wait upon you this night. I ask you to fill me and refresh me, to strengthen me and make me whole. Do not worry about anything. I'm in charge of your life. For I am ordering your steps, even the circumstances and crisis. I have ordained and ordered your steps to go through those things, so you can trust me, believe in what I'm doing. And right now, trust me, everything is going to be okay. not afraid of the things that's coming upon this world. For I want you to know that I will be with you wherever you go. I will never forsake you. I shall be with you always. Just wait upon me in every situation. And as you pray and wait on me, I will then reveal you what to do. And as you surrender and wait, I will reveal every detail of what you must do in every situation. For soon the door will open and soon you shall go, and I shall go before you. You shall be led forth with my peace. You shall be filled with comfort and joy, and I shall fill your mouth with words to speak the utterance that needs to be spoken into the hearts of my children. I'll be like a funnel that will flow living waters into the hearts of my children. It's like the rivers of living waters will burst from within your belly and flow out to the hungry and thirsty souls. I shall bring the humble, I shall bring the poor, and I shall bring you the rich, I shall bring you the people who are in need. And you will not know the difference whether they're rich or poor. You will not think about them or if they're better than the other ones. You will not think if they're more intelligent, if they're professors, or whether they're millionaires, or whether they're just a person that only has 5 cents to their name. You will see them as I see them. And you will minister according to what the needs are. But there are many people that are crying tonight, calling on my name in their cry, not knowing that I can exist. But they're crying for help. They're crying that somebody hear me, help me. And I'm sending you to them. They shall come, and when they come, they will find the very grace and the love and mercy that you found with me when you got saved, the same compassion. Let not your heart be troubled. yourself where my people are, some that are not walking in a walk with meekness. The day will come that they will come to me as I prepare, they will come and they will discover where I'm at. And I will open their eyes, for only I can open their eyes. So don't try to open their understanding. Don't try to do the work of my spirit, even if you see it. Remember, let my Holy Spirit do that work in everyone's life. Because when you allow me to do the work, many times I'm doing the work and you don't even see it. Because you don't see what I'm doing in the hearts. You don't see when I'm knocking at their door. You don't see what I'm putting in their thoughts and their minds, because I'm in charge. I have all power in heaven and earth and all this. No man can come to me except my spirit draws him. You didn't come to me one day because you decided I grow you by my spirit. You came into that church that night not really knowing what was going to happen. You weren't coming looking for anything, but I brought you there because I knew you were ready to receive me. You had come to the end of yourself, and you were ready, and when you opened up your will to me, I came in, and I set you free. Remember, I am the one that set you free. I'm the one that put my life within you. I'm the one who opened your eyes and change the whole plan of your life. I did it all. And you've been going forward for a long time. And I've been changing you from day to day, from year to year, through everything that you've gone through. And now you have come to the place that I can use you. No matter what the enemy does, no matter how many ways he attacks you, I want you to realize that I am with you. And what I'm going to do, no devil in hell can stop it. There's absolutely nothing that the enemy can do to take away what I'm calling you to do. And there's no enemy that's going to do this distraction in your life if you will be faithful. And know now that I'm preparing everything, trust me. I will bring the people that labor with you. I will bring the people who want to advance the ministry. I will remove the people that's a hindrance to your ministry. And I'm going to bring the ones that I've called to be part of your life. Many have their own ways and many are doing their own thing. Commit them into my hands and let me deal with them as a father deals with a child. Realize, every one of us, every one of my children are under construction. I am doing the work in each one of their lives in a way I see to do the work, not as man sees, but as I see. Trust me. Do not be discouraged or dismayed. Stop being so hard on yourself. Just give it all to me. Surrender everything into my hands now. Surrender your family. Surrender this church. Surrender all the finances. Surrender my children. Even the ministry you surrender to me, and surrender even the worship that, and the songs that you sing. God is going to rearrange everything now, and I'm going to put new people in positions that they're going to serve God, and they're going to follow me. They're going to follow my grace and my mercy. Thank you. Hear me, my son. This has all been a preparation. The preparation of the coming of the Lord. And it's a worldwide move of God, which I'm going to do supernaturally. And no man will get glory for it. And even as I use my children, they'll remember it's not them, but it's Christ in them. Hallelujah. Trust me. I will pray. Praise the Lord.